Renal cell carcinoma is the most common malignancy of the kidneys. The classic presentation is with the triad of hematuria or blood in the urine, a palpable mass, and flank pain. Advanced cancer characteristically extends into the lumen of the renal vein and into the inferior vena cava. This is known as tumour thrombus, which may cause a variety of strange symptoms, including a varicocele. Its pathogenesis is mainly sporadic, but there are very rare familial forms, such as von Hippel-Lindau syndrome. Key risk factors include smoking, male sex, age over 55, obesity, hypertension, and those hereditary familial syndromes. Renal cell carcinoma can be classified into three main types: clear cell, papillary, and chromophobe. Clear cell carcinoma is the most common form, accounting for 80% of cancers, and originates in the renal tubules. It's often associated with hemorrhage or necrosis. Papillary accounts for 10% of cancers. They're most commonly bilateral and have a prognosis that's much better than clear cell carcinoma. Finally, chromophobe tumours account for 5% of cases and usually have a relatively indolent disease course. The clinical features of renal cell carcinoma are dependent on the extent of disease, with one half of the number of cases detected incidentally in asymptomatic patients. The classic triad of hematuria, flank pain, and abdominal mass is uncommon and indicative of aggressive advanced disease. Similarly, presentations with symptoms of metastatic disease, such as respiratory symptoms or bone pain, is rare. Around 25% of renal cell carcinomas will develop paraneoplastic syndromes. These are a group of disorders that occur when a cancer produces hormones itself or causes the production of antibodies that can act like hormones in an abnormal response to the cancer. One common example is polycythemia, or lots of red blood cells. This is mediated by inappropriate erythropoietin production from the cancer. This can cause lots of clotting and erythromelalgia, which can make your hands pink with a burning sensation. Hypertension can also be caused by a similar mechanism where too much renin is produced. As mentioned before, advanced cases can cause a tumour thrombus, as they characteristically extend into the lumen of the renal vein. This can cause impairment and backup of the venous drainage of the pampiniform plexus in the spermatic cord, causing a varicocele. These are classically described as having the appearance of a bag of worms. For investigations, consider bloods, imaging, and biopsy. Blood tests can help assess renal function, like UECs, assess prognosis, like lactate dehydrogenase and calcium levels, and detect paraneoplastic syndromes by checking for hemoglobin in the full blood counts. Imaging can include ultrasound, which can reliably distinguish simple benign cysts from solid masses, most likely to be tumours, and can demonstrate tumour thrombosis in the inferior vena cava. CT or MRI can be used to stage the disease by assessing invasion of the perinephric tissue and by demonstrating regional lymph node involvement or metastasis. For biopsies, if imaging demonstrates a malignant renal mass with no metastatic disease evident, biopsy is not routinely indicated. On the other hand, if metastatic disease is found, biopsy of the most accessible metastatic lesion is performed to make the diagnosis. The management of renal cell carcinoma is again dependent on the extent of disease. In general, surgery is the cornerstone for localized disease and may achieve cure. When possible, partial nephrectomy is preferred as it can facilitate preservation of as much renal function as possible. Three options for surgical techniques include open, laparoscopic, or robotic-assisted laparoscopic nephrectomy. For small renal masses or in older patients, less invasive options include active surveillance, cryotherapy, in which cell destruction is achieved by local freezing, and radiofrequency ablation, which causes tumor death by coagulation from high-frequency current. Therapeutic options for metastatic carcinoma include immunotherapy using bevacizumab and interferon alpha, and tyrosine kinase inhibitors like sunitinib, and radiotherapy, which has a role in treating bone or brain mets. Interestingly, chemotherapy has shown little efficacy in metastatic renal cell carcinoma, probably due to the expression of multi-drug resistance protein 1 by tumor cells. To remember some of these important facts, I think about renal cell carcinoma as a colored disease. My mnemonic is that clear cells give you wine-colored wee, pink palms, and blue bulls. This reminds me that clear cell carcinoma are the most common type. The tumor can cause hematuria, making your urine red. Paraneoplastic syndromes can induce polycythemia, which can make your hands pink from erythromelalgia. Finally, tumor invasion into the renal vein can cause a varicocele, giving the scrotum a bag of blue worms appearance. Thank you so much for watching Townsend Teachings. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe,